From a crucial presidential primary, and this year, there's major concerns about AI and the impact it could have on your vote. And that's why Minnesota Secretary of State Steve Simon is testifying before a Senate committee this afternoon. He joins us now ahead of that hearing. Secretary Simon, thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
So, first of all, can you tell us how this opportunity for you to testify came about, and also dive more into the nature of the hearing and what it's going to be about?
Sure. Well, this is actually the committee, the Senate Rules Committee, that Senator Amy Klobuchar chairs. And she has been doing a deep dive into these AI issues generally. And she asked me to come and talk to senators and talk to the public from the standpoint of a Secretary of State about what this challenge, this AI challenge, could mean for elections in this country, particularly as we head into this presidential election year of 2024.
So for the folks watching at home this morning, what's at stake? Why should they care? Why should they be invested in the future of AI in elections?
Right. Well, you know, AI is such a challenge for all segments of our national life, right? For the media landscape, for education, for commerce, for healthcare, and elections is no different. The way I look at it is this: AI is not necessarily a new threat, but it is a new way to amplify old threats. And the old threats that I'm talking about, at least in the election sphere, is disinformation and misinformation. Bad stuff, bad facts out there about what the rules of the road are for elections. So imagine someone who utilizes a deep fake video. Maybe it's of you or your other KARE 11 colleagues. A video that is completely fabricated and manufactured that says wrong things about the election. Maybe it's wrong polling places. Maybe it's wrong rules of the road in terms of who can register and not. That has the ability to be really, really disruptive. So we have to keep an eye on it in elections, just as we do in any other segment of national life. How do you tell what's fake from what's real? It could have a real destabilizing effect.
And we have less than a year before the big general election. What else needs to be done to lessen the impact of these deepfakes?
I think some of it is common sense stuff. So, for example, just regular old media literacy. I think KARE 11 and other partners could be really helpful in this. Making sure that people are skeptical about something that they might see in a social media feed, and that they really seek trusted sources. And I don't think elections is any different from any other area of life. When it comes to healthcare, seek out a doctor. When it comes to elections, seek out the Secretary of State in your state or a local election administrator. Seek out the trusted sources, and that will make people better consumers and better able to resist these false messages, whether it's a deep fake or any other generative AI product.
All right, Secretary Simon, a part of a big conversation happening here on Capitol Hill. We appreciate your time this morning, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.